today we're going to do a release of the abductor muscles. So these are muscles of the outer hip and thigh, and they rotate your leg out. As mentioned in the blog and the previous video with piriformis, these muscles become overshortened with constantly being in a shortened position when we ride. And they need releasing to prevent us from turning toes out, knees out, and generally being quite painful. So we've already hit the piriformis through the glutes. This time we're going to hit it at the top of the thigh bone, but we're also going to hit the other abductors, sort of glute med, which is somewhere along here that leads into TFL, the iliotibial band, and then we're also going to hit what I refer to as the vasti, and that's the outer thigh muscles. There's a few other muscles around there as well, but I won't give you the anatomy lesson. Now, these can be quite tender muscles, so there's a couple of ways you can do this, and just do which one feels right for you. Okay, you don't need to completely torture yourself to do this. Now, the first one is to actually just use a ball on its own and actually just roll the ball along them. So you're just rolling it, manually just roll it out, sort of essentially giving yourself a massage, which is what we're doing. And if you notice any areas of tension, you can press, hold for about a minute, release, roll it out again. So you just go around the whole area, the sort of top of your bum, lower back area, right round the hip, and then just go up and down. Okay, now if you are quite sore in this area, that's probably your better option. And the other option, if you're a little bit more hardcore, is the foam roller. So you're gonna do the same thing, but this time on the foam roller. So you're gonna come side on, and you're gonna start outside of your thigh, top of your hip. I do it this way. There's no kind of set way you need to set yourself out, as long as you're hitting the right muscles, but I sort of go into a side plank and you're just going to roll yourself along, doing the same thing again, roll it up and down from the top of the hip down towards the knee. If you find any areas of tension, you can press, you can hold, and just releasing that whole area off. And then obviously switch and do the other side. So it doesn't matter which one you do. Like I say, this one, you can get different kinds of foam roller. You can get some softer than this one, but if they are really tense, this can be quite sore. So just starting off with the ball and rolling out manually is fine. So give that a go and let me know how you